secondary. What's the difference between the primary and secondary? Primary produce lymphocytes without exposure to antigen. فتيجي يا صالح ما تسألش فيه. Primary lymphatic organs produce lymphocytes without exposure to antigen. Secondary lymphatic organs produce lymphocytes after exposure to antigens. Give me examples for primary lymphatic organs which produce lymphocytes automatically. Bone marrow and thymus gland. Give me example for secondary lymphatic organs. Lymph nodes, spleen, tonsils, okay, and mucosal associated lymphatic tissue. So this is the difference. Okay, go ahead. Previous picture. Get me the, no, يعني the same previous picture. Same. Do we divide lymphatic organs into capsulated and uncapsulated? Yes. Which of them has a complete capsule, lymph nodes, spleen, and thymus? What about tonsils? Incomplete. Covered from one side by epithelium. And surrounded from the other side or separated from surrounding structures by incomplete connective tissue capsule. Okay, what is about the lymphatic tissue or mucosal associated lymphatic tissue? Okay, what is the mucosal associated lymphatic tissue? Lymphatic nodules scattered or aggregated? Where you can find aggregated lymphatic nodules in the body? Where you can find aggregated lymphatic nodules in the mucosa? In tonsils, where? In Peyer's patches, where? In the appendix. Do the epithelium overlying Peyer's patches has a specific type of cells? Yes, what is the type of cells specific which acts an antigen presenting or sampling cells? Or transporting cell. Antigen transporting cell. Which bring antigen from the lumen and give it to lymphocytes and macrophages. M cells. What are the M cells? Microform cells present in the epithelium overlying Peyer's patches. Okay. Okay. Get a lymph node. لغاية ما تجيب لمف نود أو تونسل أو سبلين ليه في سكتك أو سينس. Okay. This is a lymph node. Lymph node, primary or secondary lymphatic organ?
Secondary
lymphatic organ, because it produces lymphocytes in response to exposure to antigen. What is the way of antigen? How the antigen reaches to the lymph nodes? Through what?
Afferent.
Lymphatics. And then from afferent lymphatics, it passes through sinuses. Sinuses in the cortex, subcapsular, cortical, and then medullary sinuses. And after the medullary sinuses, it leaves through afferent lymphatics. So what are the types of lymph vessels present in lymph nodes? Afferent, which brings lymph, and efferent, which takes lymph outside the lymph node. What is the distribution of lymphatic tissue in lymph nodes? It is divided into cortex and medulla. In the cortex, it is present in the form of, in the outer part of cortex, it is present in the form of lymphatic nodules. Okay? Surrounded by lymph sinuses. In the medulla, it is present in the form of medullary cord, separated by lymph, medullary lymph, sinuses. In the inner part of the cortex, or the deep part of the cortex, what it is characterized by? Two things. What are these two things?
High endothelial venules.
Number two, the presence of which type of lymphocytes, T or B? T lymphocytes. T lymphocytes. So we call the deep cortical area, what's its name? Thymus. Dependent area. What is the thymus dependent area in lymph nodes? The cortical area. What else present in this area? High endothelial venules. Now, what is the function of lymph nodes? Filtration of lymph. Next picture, please. Next picture. Okay, go. لغاية ما تجيب لي أورجان تاني، أنا خلصت الانفيرود كده. Spleen. What is the function of spleen? Filtration of
blood.
Blood. Filtration of blood. Do the spleen receive afferent lymph vessels?
Should be.
No. Do the spleen get efferent lymph vessels? Yes.
So
no spleen, no afferent, but there is efferent in the lymph node. There is lymph node, there are afferent and efferent.
دكتور.
Okay? Yes.
مش العكس بالسبلين افرنت مفيش افرنت.
السبلين افرنت اند نو افرنت. انا قلت غير كده؟ Lymph node afferent and efferent. Spleen efferent, no afferent.
No afferent.
Okay? ماشي. Hi. It's surrounded by connective tissue capsule which gives trabeculae to the inside. Yes. What is the character of connective tissue capsule and the trabeculae? Connective tissue
fiber.
Containing what? Smooth muscle fibers. Is it the route for entry of the blood vessels to the bulb? Entry and leave of blood vessels to the entry and to the bulb? Into and out of the bulb? Yes. What is the parenchyma of the spleen? It is present in the form of what? Two. Red bulb and white bulb. So the lymph node contain cortex and while the spleen contain red bulb and white bulb. Okay. What is the character of white bulb? This is a picture.
Central vein.
White bulb is present in the form, is forming of central artery and not a central vein.
Oh, often artery.
Surrounded by a sheath. The sheath is called periarterial lymphatic sheath. What is the type of lymphocytes in the periarterial lymphatic sheath? T lymphocytes. So what is the other name for periarterial lymphatic sheath? Thymus dependent area. So what is the thymus dependent area in lymph nodes? Deep cortical area. What is the thymus dependent area in the spleen? Periarterial lymphatic sheath. Do the periarterial lymphatic sheath contain B lymphocytes? B lymphocytes or no B lymphocytes?
No B.
Contain B lymphocytes. Where you can find the lymphocytes in the white bulb? In the form of lymphatic nodules. So the white bulb is formed of or contains two types of cells, mainly T lymphocytes. Where? In the periarterial lymphatic sheath. What is about B lymphocytes? They are present in the form of nodules. Nodules, lymphatic nodules, or lymphatic follicles. Do we have two types of lymphatic follicles in lymph nodes, in spleen, in mucosa-associated lymphatic tissue? Primary and secondary. What is the difference between primary and secondary? What's was the difference between primary and secondary lymphatic nodules. Where we can find germinal center? In the secondary and not in the
primary.
Primary. So what's the difference between lymphatic primary lymphatic nodules and secondary lymphatic nodules? Primary lymphatic nodules has no germinal center, no activity of stimulation for B lymphocytes. While the secondary lymphatic nodules, there is germinal center. You do long exposure or second exposure of B lymphocytes in the lymphatic nodules for exposure for antigen. Antigen. Okay. What is the marginal zone? Do we have a marginal zone in the spleen? Where you can find the marginal zone? At the boundary between red bulb and
white bulb.
White bulb. Do we, what is the character of splenic sinuses? So the red bulb is formed of splenic cords separated by splenic sinuses. What are the splenic sinuses? Those are arterial side or venous side?
Arterial side, of course.
Venous side.
What
characterizes splenic sinuses? Do the lining cells are just like lining cells in all blood vessels or capillaries? No. They are elongated and not follicular. What is present in between? So the lining endothelial cells of the splenic sinuses are elongated. What is present in between the endothelial cells? Slats. Slats. Slats means spaces.
Slats.
Spaces. So the endothelial cells of blood sinuses are elongated, separated by slats. Okay, resting on incomplete layers of basement membrane, and the wall is associated with macrophages. Associated with macrophages. What is the type of circulation in the spleen? Is it opened? Is it closed? Or it is a mixture of both? Or it is mainly mucus? Mainly mucus A. أنا دخلت في حتة تانية. Or it is mainly open. Mainly open. Okay, so circulation in the spleen is mainly open, not closed. Mainly, and we mean by mainly, the open is more than the closed. Okay, what else? So I think we finished the spleen. Okay, move to another section. This is the circulation. And this is the sinuses. The picture in Ahmed, the epigenetic and splenic sinuses. The lining cells are elongated with slits in between. And the بعد one. اللي بعد يا راجل هات اي حاجه ساينس ماشي بس ساينس خلاص هات صوره هات صوره ساينس صوره مش عايز حاجه تاني what is the lymphatic organ in which we have no lymphatic nodules thymus gland the only lymphatic organ which has no lymphatic nodules is the thymus gland. Do the thymus gland is lobulated? Yes. What is the structure of each lobule? Cortex and medulla. Do the medulla of thymic lobules is continuous with each other? Yes. Okay. Common. Common for multiple lobules. Then, what are the types of cells present in the thymic lobules? Do we have stem cells traveling from the bone marrow and settle in the peripheral part of thymic lobules? Yes. So the site of production of synovocytes or new T lymphocytes is cortical, peripheral part of the cortex. They form synovocytes, undifferentiated. Undifferentiated, they have no CD4 or CD8 markers. Who makes the cells get these markers or become differentiated? Hormone. What is this hormone? What are these hormones? What we call these hormones? Thymic hormones. Who secrete the thymic hormones? Epithelial reticular cells. What is the other function for reticular epithelial cells in the cytoglobules? Because we have no connective tissue inside cytoglobules. Who supports the cells? Reticular epithelial cells. So up till now, what is the function of reticular epithelial cells? Two functions. Number one, supportive. Number two, secretory. Secretory to what? The thymic hormones. So reticular epithelial cells support the synovocytes and the epithelial cells secrete the thymic hormones. Okay, what is characterizes the medulla? What is the characteristic? There is a characteristic structure in the medulla of cytoglobules. What is this structure? Acids, corpuscles, degenerating reticular epithelial cells. Where the lymphocytes are concentrated? Do they are more numerous? Sorry. There are more numerous in the cortex and less in the medulla. And less in the medulla. Do the cortex is characterized by an important structure which protects the developing T lymphocytes against circulating blood antigens. Barrier. What we call this barrier? Blood thymic barrier. Blood thymic barrier present in the cortex or in the medulla? Cortex. So what characterizes the cortex is the presence of blood thymic barrier. What characterizes the medulla is the presence of Hazard's corpuscles. What is about the distribution of T lymphocytes? They are more numerous in the cortex than in the medulla. Okay. خلاص كده. هات اللي بعد يا عم. خلاص. هات بقى التونسلز. مش كده؟ هات التونسلز.
إبراهيم. إيش هي؟ أدي ده بعد.
أدي. تونسلز. What are? أدي. خلاص. هات السلايد. هات السلايد. Yes. ماشي. Okay. تونسلز. What are the types of tonsils do we have? Palatine. One or two? A pair of palatine tonsils. What else? Pharyngeal tonsils. What else? Lingual tonsils. Lingual tonsils are present in the base of the tongue, while the palatine tonsils are present on the sides of the oral cavity. Or the pharyngeal part. Okay, sides, in between two folds of mucous membrane. Not a problem. And the pharyngeal tonsil is present where? In the middle. Middle of what? Nasopharynx. It is one or two? It is one. Do we have what we call tubal tonsils? Tonsils surrounding the opening of the stichian tube into the pharynx? Yes, we have. Tubal tonsils. What characterizes the tonsils? What is the main characteristic? They are covered by epithelium from one side and separated from the other side, from the surrounding organs. Why? A connective tissue capsule. Okay? So what characterizes the tonsils? Apart from one side, at the surface by epithelium. And separated from the tissues by incomplete connective tissue capsule. Do the surface get the mucus? Yes. Who secretes the mucus? Mucus gland. So the tonsils are associated with mucus glands. Is there in the palatine tonsils crepes? Hover? Yes. The crepes may be primary, which you can divide to give secondary crepes. Okay, where we can find the lymphatic tissue in the tonsils? Cortex and medulla and lymph nodes. White bulb and red bulb in the spleen. Connective tissue, lamina propria in the tonsils and the mucosal associated lymphatic tissue. So where we can find the lymphatic tissue in the tonsils? In the connective tissue underlying the epithelium. The lymphatic tissue is present in the form of what? Lymphatic nodules. What is present in between lymphatic nodules? Which are mostly secondary. In between the nodules, there is a scattered lymphatic tissue. Scattered lymphatic tissue. Okay. Which tonsil, when enlarged, cause a problem in respiration? Pharyngeal. Why pharyngeal? Because it is present in the pharynx behind the posterior opening of the nasal cavity. Its obstruction, its enlargement makes the child freeze from his mouth. So when you find a child breathing, opening his mouth all the time, and breathing from his mouth, search for enlarged pharyngeal tonsil, enlarged adenoid. So another name for pharyngeal tonsil is adenoid, and it gives adenoid faces characteristic and disturbing. Abnormality in the distribution of these and so on. مش مشكلة عندي الحكاية دي. خلاص. What is the type of epithelium covering pharyngeal tonsils? Stratified squamous and keratinized. What is the type of epithelium covering pharyngeal tonsils? Respiratory. What is the respiratory epithelium? Stratified. Columnar. Ciliated epithelium with goblet cells. Okay. In the pharynx, the mucosal tissue in the pharyngeal pharynx forms folds. But in the palatine tonsils,